Hello friends, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about records at destination by using ADO enumerator. In our last video we have discussed about the ADO enumerator. If you haven't watched last video of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video before going forward. So let's start with records at destination. So what records at destination does? It doesn't save data into any external data sources like Excel files, flat files or database tables, and it saves data into memory in an object type variable. So as we have discussed in our last video, once we have data in object type variable, then by using for each loop ADO enumerator, we can read data row by row. So before going to SSDT, let's have a look of table. So this is our table as we have used in our last video. So it has total 4 columns and it has 13 rows. So go to on SSDT, and here I would like to add one more package. Then I wish to rename this package with record set destination, and here I have to use dataflow task, so I need to drag and drop, then double click on this dataflow task. So here I want to fetch data from SQL Server table, so we have to use OLADB source, and then we want to load data into a object type variable by using records at destination. So I need to drag and drop records at destination. So before configuring these two, let's create a object type variable. So go to on variables, and here I would like to add a variable, and this is our obj, and data type should be object. Now close this and go to on data flow, double click on this OLADB source. Here it would accept OLADB connection manager, so I need to click on new. As I have already made the connection, so I am going to use that one. Click on OK. Then I need to select the table. So our table is for each loop employee ADO, and go to on columns. It should have 4 columns and we want all the columns, so I need to click on OK. So we have done our source. Now I need to configure our destination and double click on this, and here as we can see inside this custom properties, we need to specify our object type variable which we have created. So this is our object type variable. Now go to our input, and we want all the inputs. Then go to on input output properties. It looks good. So basically what records at destination does, it will pick the data from our input columns and it will load data into our object type variable. Now click on OK, save this package and click on start. So package executed successfully. So it looks good. So how we can check the data? As we have discussed, I need to use for each loop container and then connect with dataflow task. Now double click on this for each loop container, go to on collections. Here I need to specify for each ADO enumerator, then we want to read data from this object type variable, and go to on variable mappings, and here I need to add a new variable, and this is for employee ID, so I can use emp ID, and data type should be integer, so I wanna use integer 32, and we need to specify a default value, that is 0. Now click on OK. As you can see, index 0, so it will hold the data from employee ID. Second employee name, so index would be 1, then salary, index would be 2, for department ID index would be 3. So go to on SSDT, and here I would like to add one more variable, and this is for employee name, so data type would be string. It looks good. Click on OK. Next we need to create one more variable, and this is for salary, so this is our salary, and so data type should be integer, so I wanna use integer 32, and default value would be 0. Now click on OK. Our last column is department ID, so add one more variable, and this is for department ID, and data type should be integer. So I want to use integer 32. Default value would be 0. Now click on OK. Again OK. So we have configured our for each loop container. Now we can execute and we can check. So it looks good. Stop this package, and we want to check our output. So we have to use a script task inside this for each loop container. Then double click on this script task. In this read only variable, we need to select all the variables which we have created. So this is our department ID, this is our employee ID, and next our employee name, and our last is employee salary. Now click on OK. I need to click on edit script. So here we need to write code to check the output. So I gonna use message box dot so. Then we need to specify DTS dot variables, then dot value dot toString, and in this variables we need to specify our variable name. So first I would like to use employee ID, so we can use employee ID. Here I want to concatenate with emp ID, so this is our emp ID. Then our second variable is emp name, so I want to concatenate with emp name, so this is our emp name. And again we need to specify dts dot variables dot value dot toString. In this variable we need to specify variable name, that is our user emp name. Then I need to use salary, so this is our salary. Then plus dts dot variables dot value dot toString. In this variable I need to use variable name, that is salary, and our last variable is department ID. So I gonna use department ID dts dot variables dot value dot toString. And here I need to specify our variable name, that is our department ID. So we have done. Now we can save it and close. Now click on OK. Now save this package and execute. So as we can see, employee ID, employee name, salary and department. For employee 2, 3, 4, 5, and it will get until employee ID 13. So package executed successfully. Now we can stop this package. I hope you have understand how we can use record set destination, and we will cover real time use of record set destination when we will do case studies. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.